going to get first place.
No whammy, no whammy. Stop!
Stop it all.
On the island of Grenada, which is a tiny island, as you know, in the southern Caribbean, it has been invaded by a multinational force, as it's being described.
To assist in the restoration of conditions of law and order and of governmental institutions to the island of Grenada, where a brutal group of leftist thugs violently seized power, killing the prime minister, three cabinet members, two labor leaders, and other civilians, including children.
She's a maniac, maniac on the floor. And she's dancing like she's never danced before.
Ho, ho, ho.
Your feelings, Father. You can't do this. I feel the conflict within you. Let go of your hate.
It is too late for me, son.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put y'all in the poorhouse at the same time. He didn't think we could do it. I won.
I lost. $1.
Thank you, Lewis.
Seven men who would risk their lives in a hurtling piece of machinery to cross the threshold of space.
Wind in the hair, lead in the pencil!
I am not enjoying this.
Keep that damn chicken quiet!
I didn't mean for him to kill it. I just wanted it to be quiet. It was a baby.
Here we stand. Worlds apart, hearts broken in two.
Let's see it. Billy Smith. It's over. And the New York Islanders have won.
Hey folks, Crazy Clamorady here again. Welcome to my 20 from 1983 series. This is game number 20 in our 20 from 1983 series, and this was the first game to use digitized graphics from actual people. And this is based on a rock band that was really popular at the time, and this is called Journey, created by Bally Midway and Marvin Glass and Associates. And, yep, the band Journey, who did Don't Stop Believin, Who's Crying Now, Open Arms, etc., they are in this, or at least black and white pictures taken of them are in this. And you control each of the five members at the time of Journey, and you try to get them to recollect stolen instruments on five different planets, and they board their spaceship, the Scarab, which appears on numerous Journey album covers, and go out to the different planets to recapture the instruments. The band members of the time were Steve Perry, lead singer, Neal Schon, guitar, Jonathan Cain, keyboards and piano, Ross Valory, bass guitar, and Steve Smith, drums. And there were numerous different members in the before this and after this. And this coincided with, I guess, a big tour that they had. The graphics from this resemble the album Frontiers, but this also has at least one song from Escape, I think, which was earlier. But here is one of the scenarios, and here is Neal Schon, and he has a jetpack. He has to fly around this cavern without bumping into the walls or getting hit by various things. And there he collected his guitar, and he has to try to fly his way back out of there safely, and he got hit. It looks really cheesy with just their heads and then these cartoony bodies. But for its time, it kind of broke new ground. And digitized graphics were a totally new thing. You know, several years later, they would show up in like Pit Fighter and then afterwards Mortal Kombat, but this was really new. You can choose which of the five places to, or planets to start on. I'm gonna start with Steve Smith on drums, and this is the easiest by far. You bounce, you can hold up to bounce high, and you can press left or right in the air to change your direction. And what you basically want to do is turn all the drums blue, but you get a special bonus if you've touched all the drums twice except for the last one. Touching them twice makes them disappear. Touching them once changes them from red to blue. And there, I'll just touch this one blue, and then I'll get a 1,000-point bonus. And then you go up to your drum set. Just hold this straight down and fire like crazy. Easy, 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 easy stage. And this time we're going to try the piano one with Jonathan Cain. And you hold up on the joystick to jump over these little glowing sticks, whatever the hell they are. Yeah, this game isn't great by any means, but I gotta admit it broke new ground for arcade games. And once you have jumped over all those on your way down, then you have to destroy these cymbals, I guess? And you have to shoot them each twice. Just make your way towards the top, and there you go, you've beaten that one. I'm probably beating these in terms of difficulty, easiest to hardest. And then we're going to do Neal Schon's stage. Yeah, you use a jetpack, just point which direction you want to fly with it. Be very, very careful. Hitting your head on a cavern wall is deadly. Touching any of those things are deadly, but you can shoot at them here. Yikes. Very tough. Each stage has a journey song. Jonathan Cain's was a Stone in Love. Steve Perry's here is obviously Don't Stop Believing. And you have to wait for the right time to go through those turnstiles. And then you collect the microphone at the bottom. And then you press fire, and I guess you sing bullets to destroy these turnstiles. This is kind of a tough game sometimes. You just have to be patient, you have to pick your spots, and just reach the top, or in some cases, the bottom of the screen. Now this is the hardest. This is Ross Valory. He's trying to get his bass guitar, and they play Still They Ride here. Getting on those rising platforms is easy enough. You can miss them and fall to your death. But this part is super hard. Trying to pick the right spot to go straight down and reach the bottom. Here is where you want to go right off the bat. Note that the collision detection is kind of tough here. But I'll show you how to beat it properly here. But yeah, for Steve Perry's stage, it's Don't Stop Believin'. Steve Smith's drums, Wheel in the Sky. Ross Valory's stage, Still They Ride. Jonathan Cain's stage, Stone in Love. And Neal Schon's stage, Chain Reaction. You get an extra life at 20,000 and then every 40,000 after that. And once you've beaten all the stages, then you are Herbie the manager. And you must protect the band, see they're on the stage, from the groupoids, I think they were called. They'll eventually get past you, but just try to get as many points as you can by blocking them with your body. See, they'll eventually get past you, and they storm the stage and recapture the instruments, and the band members run off. And you do it all over again. During this stage, there is a looped recording of Separate Ways, and for copyright reasons, I'm not going to play it there. But it was on a cassette inside the machine. Here we stand. You know the song. But we'll play Steve Smith's stage again, just because this is the easiest. But again, move straight down at the far right and fire like crazy, and you'll easily beat it. I learned that trick in the arcade on my own. This was at every single arcade. This was super popular. There were a number of games I could have put in place of this, but I decided not to. None of them were knockout good. See, they make little things more difficult. The timing of jumping over those and dropping down a floor, it gets much tougher. Yeah, some of these songs were from, Journey's album Escape, and some of them were from Frontiers. But this was released to coincide with a concert tour that Journey was undertaking. Even when you destroy a thing, another one will fire out shortly after. And it killed me. Or killed Neal Schon. Steve Perry, of course, has since been replaced as lead singer by Arnel Pineda, and he's very good. And we'll play as Steve Perry again. You get points for going through the turnstiles. There's points to be had in a lot of different things. And Steve Perry had one hell of a voice. I used to be able to not quite reach his range, but I could sing a number of Journey songs. I used to be really, 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 really good at singing. And since COVID hit and I've had to wear a mask all the time, my voice has not gotten as much use as I'd like. But I'll put in my initials here. That's Journey by Bally Midway and Marvin Glass and Associates in 1983. This was game number 20. Well, I hope you enjoyed. I look forward to having you join me on other games in the series. There's Ross Valory's stage again. But yeah, you just go on the rising platforms here and just try to catch the bass guitar and then fire your way, your safe way down to the bottom. It's best to go to the far right, I guess, and shoot your way down to safety. But that was Journey, created by Bally Midway and Marvin Glass and Associates in 1983. Well, I thank you for joining me for game number 20, Journey, in my 20 from 1983 series. Welcome to my 20 from 1983 series. Hope to see you soon for game number 19. Y'all have a good one, everybody. Bye-bye.